Hello friends from the wheelchair gang, Tharries here, and welcome back to another Doctor Who leak video. Hooray! Specifically, we're back on Reddit. Reddit leak season is back in full swing, and guess who's here to cover them all? Well, it's yours truly. But before we get into it, if you could just do me a teeny tiny little favour and click that subscribe button. We're trying to get to 10k by the end of the year, and I can't move the subscriber number unless you subscribe. I don't know, it might be a glitch, but if you do subscribe, the number goes up, so please do that. It would really make me very happy. I like big numbers. What can I say? I used to love it in maths where we'd get to, like, you know, 1,000 or 10,000 in particular. So just make me get to that number and I will be very, very happy. But with that said, let's get into the leak. Now, this is from Crimson King, who you'll remember has done some leaks in the past if you've been following these leaks for long enough. And it's specifically about the Doctor Who 60th anniversary. Doctor Who 60th anniversary leaked info, to be specific. Alright everyone, I know I've been in the dark, but I didn't want to discuss any further leaks, as not much else was really left to talk about in terms of Series 13. Filming is still going strong, and pretty much all of the complete CGI scenes, such as space scenes and things like that, have already been finished. They're doing everything in their power to get the first trailer out by August/September. Right, now, that's interesting to me because I said in the last video that if it's going to be releasing in October, then realistically we should be getting a trailer in July, because that's what happened with Series 11, and a release of Episode 1 on November 1st. Now, this would imply that, in fact, there isn't a Halloween episode, or no connection to Halloween whatsoever, despite the pumpkin. So I'm assuming what this means is if the first episode does take place on November 1st, it'll be like a remnant of Halloween, kind of similar to how when in, like, New Year's Day specials, perhaps they'll have, like, remnants of Christmas trees about. I'm guessing that's what the pumpkin would signify if it was to release on November 1st. However, I do still find it weird that it would be so prominent if there wasn't a Halloween episode, but carrying on. What I'm here to talk about today is something many people have been theorising about for some time now. Now, while certain plot elements have yet to be discussed by Chibnall, early agent conversation and in-the-works contract agreements and pre-production scheduling and planning has it very clear what's going to happen in the 60th anniversary of Doctor Who. In terms of Series 14, that is seemingly being put on the back burner till 2024, which, I'm going to be honest, I'm really not happy with if that's the case, because that would mean that next year, 2022, we get nothing, 2023, we presumably get the one special, which would be the 60th, and then 2024, we would have a series properly, which we don't know whether would be Jodie or someone new. I'm really not happy with that. That seems like an incredibly low amount of content to spread across such a large amount of time, especially if Series 14 turns out to also be 8 episodes, as has been speculated a few times, with plans for a 90-minute holiday special featuring the Daleks to release in 2022. That could well be what we've already seen filming before. Although, as I always do, playing devil's advocate with this, it could just be someone putting two and two together. In terms of the 60th, we aren't getting one big Day of the Doctor-style individual special. Rather, we will be getting one 11-part epic anniversary series taking all the way through to 2023. Okay, well, that would alleviate some of my fears about only getting one story in 2023 after nothing in 2022. But at the same time, I don't know how you could spread that across 11 stories. The plan is to have an 80-minute episode take place on the 23rd of each month through November, with several former Doctors set to return to star in individual episodes to all come together in the ending. Which, to be honest, I kind of like the idea of. I suppose that each returning Doctor would build a new sense of hype. It would almost be like getting sort of advent calendar type thing. But instead of obviously once a day in 1 month, it would be across several months in a year. So that would be quite cool. While Christopher Eccleston seems reluctant to return to Who, no real surprise there, in the screen format, the plans are to get Paul McGann, David Tennant, Matt Smith, and Peter Capaldi to all return. The only iffy one would be Matt Smith, as they are trying to see how filming with the 60th season could work with the Game of Thrones prequel he is starring in. Not gonna lie, right? I want them to get Matt Smith. Matt Smith's my personal favourite. David Tennant, I always knew was going to be a shoe-in, and I'm glad McGann's making an appearance. To be honest, Capaldi was the one that I was least sure about, because he is getting on now. I believe he's like 65. So I'm glad that that is one that's very much on the table, but I want them to get Matt Smith. I think his contribution to New Who especially is kind of overlooked on occasion, considering, you know, he kept Doctor Who popular after its most popular period in the David Tennant era, and brought it international acclaim through Series 6 in particular, but going all the way to the 50th. So I feel like his contribution and that era's contribution shouldn't go unrecognised. So I really hope they do get him, because I think he's a vital, important piece of New Who. There have been talks to have Omega return for this anniversary, as he was the main threat in the first anniversary special, but there have been some legal issues. This is something I've spoken about before, and I'm not sure a lot of people know. So I believe the same company who want to make the K-9 film also own the rights to Omega, hence why you've not seen Omega come back in the new series. So I know people like Confused Adipose Joe, he really wants Omega to come back, but I don't think he will come back because of the legal issues there. So as much as I'd love him to come back, it makes sense that they wouldn't be able to get him. With the right to use him in a Doctor Who format that isn't Big Finish. It's kind of weird though that they'd let him be in Big Finish but not on screen, that's strange. There were discussions early on to see if a big named voice actor, like James Earl Jones, would be able to voice Omega, but since they aren't really sure if they will even be able to use him, most of the story elements are very much in the early stages, but plans are to start filming in 2022. That way they have time to come up with a concrete story that will be pleasing for fans of all eras of the show. So wait, so if it's filming next year, and we're in July of this year, that's not that much time to think of a story, really. If it's not being thought of now, that's a bit concerning, really, because if they're filming it next year, you'd hope that they'd have a pretty concrete idea of what they're doing, because otherwise they would just be filming random things, which would be strange. I mean, I suppose stories can change quite a bit in their editing process. There's a great video talking about how Remembrance of the Daleks was essentially saved in its editing process, but I would hope that by the time they get to filming it, they have a pretty concrete idea of what the plot is. And that's about it in terms of this leak. Obviously, the most interesting thing is the fact that we would be getting Paul McGann, David Tennant, Matt Smith, and Peter Capaldi all back, along with presumably Jodie Whittaker as well, if she is still the current incumbent by that time. Bit disappointed to not see any other classic names even mentioned, although McGann, I'm very happy that he is going to be in it, because I did think that him not being in the 50th, I always thought that was a massive wasted opportunity, considering he was literally in the other studio in costume. You could have not just had him make a cameo in the 50th. But regardless, my only concern would be the whole Matt Smith thing, and they're a bit iffy about him being able to come return because of the Game of Thrones prequel. I'm not gonna lie, I really want him to come back. He's my favourite Doctor, and if he didn't, I'd be bitterly disappointed. I'd kind of be like, you know, fans in the 80s who realise that Tom Baker isn't coming back. That would be the sort of level it would feel for me, I guess, because he was the Doctor I grew up with the most, you know. While, yes, I started with Tennant, Matt Smith was the first era I watched all the way through, so he's very important to me, and I'd really hope that they could get him in on the 60th anniversary celebrations. Plus, Chibnall's also wrote for him as well, so it makes sense for him to be in the celebrations. But let me know what you guys think about this leak in the comments below. What do you think of the idea of them splitting the 60th anniversary into multiple episodes rather than just one big one? Comment down below your thoughts and subscribe if you're new, and I will see you later.